At the Formulator's Lab Bench, we're going to talk about testing cosmetics for bacteria, yeast, and mold, and any cosmetic formulations that contain water in them, whether it's a lotion, a cream, a shampoo, conditioner, hair mist, body wash, they must be pre-market tested for bacteria, yeast, and mold. They cannot be contaminated and released for sale. And there's two different tests that are important. There's challenge testing, and there is plate counts testing. Challenge testing, you do one time on a new formulation. Once that formulation is good to go and you just really love it, you send it to a cosmetic lab, a sample of it, and they induct household bacteria, yeast, and mold in it for about a month. And it either passes or fails, and it'll tell you if your preservative system is effective or not. The next one is plate counts testing, and that is when you make a batch before you sell it. You have to make sure that you have not introduced bacteria, yeast, and mold, and that you use GMP, that none of your ingredients were contaminated. And so what you do is after you make your batch, you send a bit to the cosmetic lab, and you get results right away, very quickly. And if it passes, then you can release that for sale. There's also do-it-yourself testing that is very similar to the plate counts testing, except that you don't get the plate counts of the bacteria, yeast, and mold, say that it has that in it. You don't know how many growing on a slide. We're going to test several products today that we retain for samples. So we retain the formulations from the pro courses and even our lab classes, the individual classes. We retain samples of those over 3 years, and then we do what's known as real-time testing. And we test these retained samples to make sure there's not any bacteria, yeast, and mold in them. We subject these formulations to conditions a consumer would, like ones that are in a jar, we put our hands in, we use it. We take it into hot and cold and different into the shower, into humidity to see, because all those conditions can affect the stability of that formulation. These are the retained samples we're testing today. This cream was recently taken to Italy. I packed it with me in my suitcase. It was taken on 4 different planes and 6 different trains and in different heat and cold conditions. These are the do-it-yourself kits. This is what comes in the kits. These are the slides. And the pink slide, it shows if yeast and mold will appear. The yellow side is if a bacteria appears. Also, you want to make sure that it has not expired. There's an expiration date on each of these slides. You will need these sterile cotton applicators, these swabs. It's very important that you have the sterile swabs. So some of the kits come with them and some of them don't. If they don't, you'll have to purchase them yourself. You want to make sure and wear gloves. And when you open these, open them from the top and don't touch the cotton swab at all. You don't want to contaminate that swab. It's very important that you label your sample. You put the date, the time, what the sample is, and also what is the source. So these are our retained samples, and they each have a batch recorded number on them. You open it from the top down, and you just have your slide ready. Do not touch the plates at all in there. And then you swab your sample. And just, you don't need a lot of it. You just slide it on. You use one swab per slide. Do not use one per both sides. Get a clean one, swab it again, and then apply it to the yellow side. And then carefully place it back into the container. Make sure that it is labeled. It's helpful to have an incubator. You don't have to have an incubator, but an incubator is very consistent and it's quick. You can leave these in a warm place for 7 days and then you can read them. But generally, to test for bacteria, you put it at 35 Celsius and you check it after 24 hours. And then for yeast and mold, you lower the temperature to 30 Celsius and you do for another 24 hours and then check it. I'll evaluate them now for bacteria, yeast, and mold. And I look at the slides very carefully. Again, the pink slide, it'll show if there's yeast and mold on it. And then the yellow slide is if bacteria appear. And in the pro courses, we have all kinds of examples of what it looks like if there's different types of bacteria, different types of mold, different types of yeast. This kit does come with a handout of just some forms of bacteria and what to look for. And it's helpful, but sometimes there's things you're not sure of. And so that's why I've, over the years, have researched and found the different, what it will show up like on the slide. So you know what you're looking for. But generally, you'll see it. So far, it's free of bacteria, yeast, and mold, but I'm gonna reduce the temperature to 30 degrees Celsius, and I'm gonna run it for another 24 hours, so it'll be a total of 48 hours. These are the instructions that come with the kit, and they show you some types of bacteria and what it'll look like, and also how to use it and how to dispose of them. It's important that you follow the instructions for the kit that you have and that you dispose of them properly. It's been another 24 hours, and so I'm going to check all the slides again for any signs of bacteria, yeast, or mold. Testing of cosmetic formulations for bacteria, yeast, and mold is extremely important, and it has to be done. And once you do it, you're not so scared, and you know that you're offering a safe formulation to your customers.